I'm a big fan of comic book movies. What's not to love? You've got superpowered heroes, cool gadgets, awesome action, and don't forget the most important part, the supervillains that drive the plot. But I reckon in real life, there's something scarier than Bane, Lex Luthor, and Loki put together. The arch nemesis of the human race, the virus. Now, if you've ever had the common cold, you've had the joy of experiencing a virus, but what are they? I like to think of them as the microbiological equivalent of Agent Smith from The Matrix. They are a program written in genetic code, a strand of either DNA or RNA wrapped in a protein coat, whose sole purpose is to take over the cells in your body and turn them against you to replicate themselves. Viruses are absolutely tiny. They're about a hundredth the size of a bacterium, and they're impossible to see under a normal microscope. Even electron microscopes struggle because they operate on molecular scales. In my mind, viruses are the ultimate bad guy, and here are five reasons why you should be more scared of them than you probably are right now. Normally, viruses are quiet and unsuspecting until they come into contact with a living target cell. Then their villainous intent is revealed. They latch on to the outside of the cell and inject their genetic material, turning that cell into a virus-making factory. And that leads me on to the next villainous point. They want to take over your body by replicating themselves over and over. Once hundreds or even tens of thousands of cloned viruses have been made inside a cell, that cell will then burst, releasing these new viruses to then find new cells to take over. Some viruses, in fact, like the flu, have developed tendril-like forms which grow outside of the cell to help spread the infection. Reason three is pretty gross. Some viruses don't just want your cells, they want their skin as well. These viruses not only have that protein coat, but they have an envelope of lipids around it, which is made from chunks of your cells' membranes. This envelope actually helps the viruses get in your cells. Some viruses go down the horror movie monster route and lurk inside your body. Let's say you end up with a cold sore virus in your mouth for some reason. Firstly, that virus will reproduce in the skin tissue on the first layer. But after that first round of reproduction, it can find itself in the nerve cells, where they can lay in clusters at the nerve ends, and they can be dormant there for any amount of time until they want to resume their attack. The fifth and final reason why viruses are so deadly is probably the scariest. They don't give up. We're not even sure if viruses are alive. They don't really fit all of the characteristics of life, so they're in this grey area. But last March, Pithovirus cibericum was restored from the permafrost after being frozen for 30,000 years, and it was still infectious. If that doesn't give you nightmares, I don't know what will. So if anyone from Marvel is watching, you can have this idea for your next baddie for free. Big thanks to Dr. Bella at the Centre for Virus Research at Glasgow University for their fascinating footage of viruses under the microscope. If you want to have a look at more of it or just more cool stuff, check out VSource 2's Mind Blow episode at the end of this vid.